I'm so fresh, man. Man, y'all scared to do it how I do it.
Probably wear them 2 or 3 times and throw them away. As soon as the front's bent up, I get a new pair.
How many shoes do you own?
Big brother, like I say, I wear them 2 or 3 times and throw them away. But I usually buy 10 or 12 pair every time I'm in the mall to keep from having to go to the mall weekly.
However, success never comes without a price. In recent years, Nike has been exposed for exploiting its workers to an extreme degree. Offering immigrants work, they would then take their passports and force them to work under their conditions. With nowhere to turn for help, these exploited workers would have no choice but to give in to Nike's demands. Though it's nothing new for sweatshop workers to be offered low wages, something else was going on here entirely. Workers would have to pay a year's wages up front, and then this debt would be used against them. They had essentially nothing to help themselves escape from poverty. The company's slogan, "Just Do It," took a whole new meaning when it was discovered that they were virtually using slave labor to manufacture their goods. As this expose by an Australian news channel presents, there were virtually Nike signs everywhere in the factory that they went undercover in. So indeed, these poor living conditions are none other than the direct responsibility of Nike as a company. These workers are forced into small rooms to live together, they feel virtually helpless and hopeless here, and they wish that there was something they could do to better the living conditions. To make matters worse, cramped living conditions and filthy floors are not the only problems here. Let outside by the workers, the reporter stands witness to where the water comes from. The conditions that the workers are forced to live in are almost unbelievably bad. Fortunately, thanks to the work of this news team, these conditions do not go unnoticed forever. The international exposure of Nike's illicit activities was of great embarrassment to them as a company. After being exposed on national Australian television, Nike had no choice but to defend their actions. Like many clothing manufacturers before them, and many more to come, they claimed that they did not know about the horrific living conditions or the human trafficking cases that were involved with their company. It's moments like this that make you wonder what goes on behind the company's public image of sports stars. Just how often does Nike exploit its workers, and to what degree? The real issue is that as long as they have middlemen manufacturing their clothing, they will continue to shirk responsibility, ravaging small countries while profiting. Unless something is done with international labor regulations, companies like Nike may just never stop in their ways.